perhaps the most important decision I guess you have to make as a young scholar is to decide about what subject you're going to do your PhD on. And then also a very important question is where and who's going to be your supervisor. And that being said, also, I think if you want to establish yourself as a scholar, I think it's important that you don't simply spend 3 or 4 years of your life on a PhD without getting out of your bedroom and your office. I think it's very important that you engage with the external world, relevant stakeholders, but also that you reach out to your colleagues, attend conferences, present your papers, and don't wait. I would say perhaps the best advice I could give to younger scholars is that don't wait for the perfect article before publishing. Don't wait for the perfect book. Perfection is not of this world. It's important that once you have started working on a topic, you get out there, you attend, you present, and essentially try to get as much feedback as you can along the during the course of your writing. And also you have to reach out essentially to the extent that it's important to get some feedback. And also I would say perhaps what I've seen more and more, and I think it's a good development, is that I can see more and more people publishing on blogs. And I think it's a good idea. In fact, my advice to younger colleagues is whenever you're working on a very new topic or whenever you have something new to say, don't wait for the 10,000 word article or don't wait for the book to be completed. Get a 1,000 word post out there and circulate it, get feedback, and then it's going to improve your research along the way. So I would say start with a post, publish a scholarly article, and follow this by another post to tell essentially the world, these are my findings. If you want to know more, please see the published work there. And perhaps if I may say also, if I may add, I think it's important also for academics perhaps to take not the career breaks, but essentially during the course of the PhD, what I found personally very helpful is that I took breaks to work in the real world. And it has benefited my research. So from time to time, essentially, I step back from pure scholarship to actually engage in policy making or at least work for international organizations or law firms. I think it makes you a well-rounded academic when you also take the time to step back from just the production of scholarship to actually get your hands dirty. So I think I would advise, usually when I have PhD students, if I tell them if at all possible to spend 1 year working in the relevant environment, because this is going to make the PhD a much better product at the end of it. If you can, obviously, take the time to do something else during the course of the PhD. But I would say also before you look into an academic career, I would say it's quite, I mean, in law it's easier, I guess, than in other subjects, but certainly personally value colleagues who have worked as lawyers before joining the School of Law. And also it's good also sometimes to take a break during the course of your career to do something else. It does tend to re-energize people and give them new insight or fresh ideas.